picture my cousin Igor beat. The basement's going scandalous, scandalous.
Yeah, man, it's your boy Mangy, man. And I'm in the mix with DJ Igor beat. What it do?
It's your boy Monette,
and you're in the mix with DJ Igor beat. What he do?
It's your boy Mo Gun, CEO of Beats Entertainment. You in the mix with DJ Igor Beats. What it do?
Yo, what's up? It's your boy White Out, one part of the Bay Boys of Comedy. You in the mix with my little big cousin, DJ Igor Beats. What it do?
It's your boy Rascal of Beats Entertainment, and you're in the mix with DJ Igor Beats. What it do?
It's your boy Gutter, you know, it's the mob. And you in the mix with Igor Beats. What it do?
We got Mad Mondays coming up. Shouts out to the Bay Life Radio staff. Bottom Pound Rap Media, Square Vision, One World Magazine, Smith Smooth Cuts, Precious Love Catering, Uncle Paul's Barbecue, Lollipop Cannabis Candy, Coast to Coast DJs, The Coalition, DJ West Coast Division.
What he do?
And all the wonderful fathers around the world, huh?
Shit, can't even pitch. I'm home runs out the dugout. I'm D-Wise from the bomb. Z's Oakland slums. Fuck what you heard. I'm in the lane on my own. One of three kings. Respect my throne. I see you on that book bullshit. I'm ready with a full clip. Sure, Mike, right hip. You gotta back up. Way back the fuck up. I got a short rope. No need for D to act up. A nigga loose with the cannons. Lyrics, I start splatting on your ass with a passion. Nigga, don't get your ass whipped. I'm well equipped to spark that shit. Cause I bang over beats that bounce. Smoke weed by the ounce. Hit you hard where it counts. Show up but your shit unannounced. Laugh up in your face and then bounce. Boing. It's just some rap shit that I was raised with. Bill Ross is Fred Rex and Joe Quick shit. Alright, man. That's all I need to do. That's it. You can't fuck with
me.
You know who I be.
Why you sleeping on people with the intricate plot?
I want it all, living this motherfucker.
You can't fuck with
me.
You really can't fuck with me.
How many motherfuckers got a fight? Cause I'm no wrong nigga to fuck with.
Hey,
Bay Life All Day TV Channel Zero, man. I'm with a daddy from 11-5, if you didn't know, huh? Straight out the lion's mouth, yeah. And your bitch, if you didn't know. You know what I'm saying? It's a worldwide movement right now.
The greatest scam I ever ran was convincing myself that I didn't need my mama to grow up. I had to take care of my family, my grandma, my brothers, and my sister. I was just a kid trying to raise kids. And when it came to finessing, I was a genius.
Usually sell this many gift cards.
We're youth pastors with the Neon Genesis Evangelical First Episcopal Baptist Irish Catholic Church of Douglas T. McKenzie. So just gonna do some gift card purchases to give out in the raffle.
You can slide whenever.
My mama's side is Filipino and my daddy's side is black. Not everyone accepted us. I didn't know I was supposed to behave a certain way because of how I looked. The truth is, I grew up and became my mama because she was a survivor and we were survivors.
God is good. God is great. Let us thank you for our food. Amen.
I'm sorry. That's why we don't sorry. Let you say
yeah. 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 Oh, you want to say grace? I can say grace.
I'm a stoop kid. I've seen everything on it. If you never moving, they're going to catch your ass.
When I pull up, you can see me and beam in a sling, find good up. Been on neck so long, wish I would lift a foot up. Make it hard for him to look up. It's Jonah with the cook up. I can knock a bad bitch with no diamonds on my neck. 100K for a rainy day, grinding at his best. I'ma keep blowing on him, see me shining out the chest. Niggas know you couldn't touch a line while I ain't a flesh, Jonah.
Whole crew high side when I pull up. On the party outside, I glide when I pull up. In my crew with Flint, boy, it ain't stolen. All the bitches wanna ride.
Always keep a hammer on me when I'm rolling through the rich. And all my B-10 homies, they don't play that shit. Ain't no future in your friend, make you lay down quick. Even though it's freezing cold in the North Pole, when them hot things blow, better lay low. Nigga, you might even need a vest. Rolling through the West, they might put you as a rest. You don't wanna test, so don't be acting like a thug. Cruising through the dub, you might catch a couple slugs. They don't show no love, even in the belly of the beast. Deep up in the East, you know them niggas know the creep. Put your ass to sleep so you don't wanna put in work. Better go to church. Have your body in the dirt. Put you on the shirt. Cause my whole crew high side when I pull up. On the party outside, I glide when I pull up. In my crew with Flint, boy, it ain't stolen. All the bitches wanna ride when they see me rolling. My whole crew high side when I pull up. On the party outside, I glide when I pull up. In my crew with Flint, boy, it ain't stolen. All the bitches wanna ride when they see me rolling, 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 rolling. See me rolling, 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 rolling.
Fake life, fake life, fake life, fake life.
Bitch, we them niggas who really running this bag. And don't ask me if I got it, it's on me, don't do the lag. And for the whips, use the back camera when I back in. Tim drop 10 and it's my niggas trying to stack 10. Yeah, turk niggas by the bag and we sticked up. Still rocking with the same niggas, only gang, I can't switch up. Tim, man, sit a pussy nigga down, ain't no getting up. Applying pressure, told my niggas it ain't no letting up. It ain't no passes, we see them niggas and we on them. Nigga, I ain't find shit in the county, only time we throw them. Every time my niggas tripping the slime, we tryna dump some. Broke bitch sound stupid, bitch, I see if she can hold some. No time for broke shit, on the road, steady chase hunters. Niggas ain't having paper, niggas fiends told the plug to front. Drop my nuts in any situation, nigga, I ain't running. Anytime we in them niggas section, all them balls on us. Hoes on us, niggas mad, and they chose on us. Don't trust that nigga with the pole, that nigga froze with him. Don't push up on us, or don't God, I'ma blow, niggas. 5-6-6-1-9, it ain't no hoe in it. We them niggas who really running this bag. And don't ask me if I got it, it's on me, don't do the lag. Use the back camera when I back in. Tim drop 10 and it's my niggas tryna stack 10. Yeah, turn niggas by the bag and we sticked up. Still rocking with the same niggas, only gang, I can't switch up. Tim, man, sit a pussy nigga down, ain't no getting up. Applying pressure, told my niggas it ain't no letting up.
Oh, yeah, ain't giving passes, this black all plastic. Talking on the net, niggas high power capping. Running through these bulls, why you niggas steady acting? Know I got it on me, I'ma use it, ain't just flashing. Get it out the bitch, stack it up, then I stash it. Bro, gotta play, line it up, we gon' lash it. Me to wipe up the tool, I'ma blast it. Bitch, we them niggas, you ain't even gotta ask it.
Bitch, we them niggas who really running this bag. And don't ask me if I got it, it's on me, don't do the lag in. Four whips, use the back camera when I back in. Tim drop 10 and it's my niggas tryna stack 10. Yeah, turn niggas by the bag and we sticked up. Still rocking with the same niggas, only gang, I can't switch up. 10 milli sit a pussy nigga down, ain't no getting up. Applying pressure, told my niggas it ain't no letting up.
Yo, yo. Hey. Happy Friday. Yeah. I'm in the spaceship, man. Come on. Come on. Come on.
Boy, stop.
Yeah, I'm with the funnies.
Laughing out loud, man. It's how I get this money. Man, you know how I'm moving. Man, you see what I'm doing. All the paper I'm pursuing. Yeah, with the funnies, laughing out loud, man, that's how I get this money. That's how I get this money. That's how I get this money.
Welcome, 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 man. This is Mad Mondays, the podcast. We live, bitch. And you already know what it is, man. It's your boy, Whiteout, a.k.a. Two Man. And I want to say thank you, everybody, for tuning in on another Monday, man. I just want to say God is good all the time. And without him, we wouldn't be here right now, amen? Come on, come on, come on. And then this shit wouldn't be possible without a little big cuss on the ones and twos, as well as running the spaceship. Little big cuss, Igor Beats. What it do?
What it do, man? How y'all feeling, man? What's
happening? Man, it's Monday. What is this?
Come on, season 6, episode 4.
Okay.
Let's go.
Okay.
Running laps around these
sets. Yeah. 2 years strong,
come
man.
On, the
hello,
podcast
man.
Continues,
yeah,
man.
Yeah. With you or without you.
You feel me?
But everybody that's following us on twitch.tv/BayLifeRadio, we always want to show y'all love because y'all went to the app, downloaded it, followed us.
Right.
And be commenting and all the shit. I ain't got my computer in front of me today, though. But all the people that's chatting will continue chatting later. We definitely appreciate y'all's support. But then we don't want to make nobody feel no kind of way. So we want to give everybody that's following us on Instagram the same love, man. But like we tell you every motherfucking Monday, the Twitch side is the best side.
Let's go.
And we do have a phone line, man, for the people that want to call in. You want to talk about some shit. You got something that you want to promote. Please feel free to do so. 510-563-7819. I will repeat for the people that went to school on the yellow bus. 510-563-7819. That's Bay Life Radio, man. Tap in and talk to us. We'll talk back like on some real shit. But little Big Cuz, how you doing, man?
Man, I'm good, man.
Come on, man. Talk to me. I'll talk back.
The weekend was live, man. We had a couple of nice shows. You know what I'm saying? I'm just waiting for this.
Hello!
Come on, man!
Hello!
I'm waiting for it. We'll be right here in a minute. You know
Yeah, man. Come on, man.
Bay Boys of Comedy, huh?
Come on, man. The reunion. I think I'm four shows in on this G thing, man. It's like a reunion, man. Like, you know what I'm saying? I'm looking forward to it too a little bit because I ain't got shit going on but a little Mexican trip and some little lightweight shit going on this Monday. But I'm definitely getting ready for, man, we are a month, 2 days away, man.
Come on, man.
Get your
Let's
tickets
go.
Now, man. BrownPepperTickets.com or you can catch me in traffic. But please get your tickets.
So
please
support,
come and support.
Fire up right now.
Yeah. Oh, it's up right now? Okay, yeah, so boom, right man. Now. You know what it is, man. Come on, man. Presents the Bay Boys of Comedy Reunion Show. Saturday, August the 3rd at the Black Repertory Theater, man. Doors open at 7. Show starts at 8. Hosted by Whiteout. DJ Igor Beats on the ones and twos, man. We got starring Big Tree, the original Bay Boys of Comedy. Big Tree, Jay Rich, Leon Gibson, Rico the Great. We're giving prayers up to moms, too, man. I hope you're doing well. But, yeah, Rico the Great, Antoine Johnson, as well as Marcus Polk Mouse. And then we got one lady in the building. Ain't no telling how many people we're going to have, though. But this is the lineup. Aisha the Truth will definitely be on the mic, man, because without her, I wouldn't have took this comedy shit to the next level. And without her, I got to give her roses, man, like on some real shit. But it's definitely going down, man. Tickets on sale again at brownpeppertickets.com. General admission is $25. $25. VIP seats, two front rows is $50. And then if you want to boss up and really be on some boss up shit, then we got VIP tables, man, for $200. Everybody gets a drink. You know what I'm saying, for the VIP as well as the VIP tables, man. We got vendors, we got food. I'm still looking for like 5 vendors. So if y'all know somebody that's selling merchandise when it comes to selling their product, their business, you know what I'm saying, tell them to tap in with me. I got 5 slots left. We'll be having raffles and hella funny, man. It's definitely going down. If you've ever been to a Bay Boy Comedy Reunion show, then you already know, man, I go hard in the paint. And Waka Flocka voice, I go hard in the motherfucking paint, nigga.
For sure.
You know what I'm saying? All my niggas is funny. They're bringing the funny. I got my nigga Polk coming out of retirement. He don't even do comedy no more. You know what I'm saying? He focus on his family and his job and shit, though. He be like, man, I got to come out one time. And we will be giving a tribute to my man, Leroy Stanfield Jr., representing Go Baby Productions, because for the people that don't know, Leroy suffered a few strokes in the last couple years, and it's to the point now, I believe, that he's paralyzed on one side, and he's really not doing good. But you know what I'm saying? We keep him for showing this in our prayers, for sure. We keep the Go Baby Productions lit, you know what I'm saying? Especially when it's coming from me, you know what I'm saying? So, yeah, we'll definitely have a little time right there to dedicate to him. He ain't dead, but, you know what I'm saying, he's not doing good right now, man. So if anybody that fears God and believe in God, man, just put one up for him and his family as well. But it's definitely going down August the 3rd, man. I'm looking forward to it. I got vendors. Like I said, I got vendors. I got food. I got alcohol. I got whatever you need. And we doing it at the Black Repertory Theater. And this show might really be, it might really mean something, though, because from the word on the streets, you know what I'm saying, we don't know how long the Black Rep is going to be around. So we definitely want to support this Black establishment that's been keeping it lit for years. I'm 49, and I'm talking about when I was a baby. People was doing plays. They had summer programs. They did a lot of shit for the community, as well as the city of Berkeley, as well as Oakland, man. So that would be another reason to come to it, though. But I definitely want y'all to come get this funny, man. It's definitely going down, and I'm looking forward to this shit. Once again, tickets are on sale at brownpeppertickets.com, or you can catch me in traffic, man. I got them, like, on some real shit. Like, real shit. We finna turn it up one time, man. Like, for real. I'm looking forward to it. Little Bit Cuz, how was your week, man? I heard you had a lot of things going on. I did finally pull up.
Come on, man.
I finally pulled up to the brunch.
You got that sandwich?
At Sweet Fingers and got that sandwich.
Got that sandwich?
Got that chicken sandwich with the egg and everything he said. Nigga, I had to order the sauce on the side, but they gave it to me. That shit was hot as fuck. The nice little pineapple.
And they hot is different from our hot.
And
man,
that shit was hot, nigga.
Yeah, I know.
That shit was bumble clock hot, nigga.
Yeah, yeah. It's like way defensive. Like,
right, right. Because I only did the finger. Funny. I did the finger and was like,
oh, yeah.
Oh, shit. So automatic.
Imagine if you spread that on your brain. You feel me?
So shout out to my nigga Clyde and all the staff at Sweet Fingers right there. What's the address, Lil Bit Cuz?
5859 Foothill Boulevard.
Man, we just going to say Seminary and Foothill right on the corner, you man. You know where it's at. It's So Town Biz and the food is delicious. They still got the oxtails and everything else, though. But Lil Big Cuz got a brunch that he plays music at from, what, 2 to 3?
Sundays. Nah, actually, I play from 11 to 4.
Okay, 11 to 4.
It started out 11 to 2, then 11 to 3, now 11 to 4.
Okay.
You know, come in and, all brunch prices apply.
Yeah, for sure. And, for sure. Don't also, come in there broke.
Also.
Come with at least $25, nigga. I'm going to just tell you that. Because all you're going to probably, if you come with less than $20, all you're going to probably get is the plantain. What's that shit called?
The plantain.
The plantain and some water.
You get a beef
and some water. Don't come in there on no broke shit. Don't try to come in there and use our name and be like Lil Big Cuz said what it do and all that other shit. Because it's not happening. That nigga's going to charge you and look at you like you're stupid. Nigga. Right. So, yeah.
But he do got a lunch special every day, Monday through Friday. He got a $22 lunch special. Come in and get the oxygen.
$22 stool. Plus tax. $25, me? Nigga. So
go.
Don't go in there on no broke shit. Don't go anywhere on no broke shit. Like, right. For real, if you ain't got it, man, just don't go.
Just don't go.
Like,
save,
for real.
Save up and get there.
Yeah, come on. So
there's a lot of places I'm trying to save to go.
Me too. I'm finna go to Mexico next week, nigga, for a whole week.
Arriba!
Ooh, I'm looking forward to it.
I heard that.
I ain't drinking no alcohol. I ain't doing shit all week. Fuck the 4th of July. All that shit, nigga. I'm going to do all that
so
shit
you flying
in Mexico.
Or what?
So I'm driving to L.A. and then we get on the boat in L.A. and Long Beach.
Oh, you going on a cruise like the Ensenada and all that.
So Ensenada and Cabo. We going to Cabo first and then we going to Ensenada. So I'm going to do the food, and then I'm going to try to get on the mic. But, like, you know what I mean? I'm a town nigga on this motherfucker, man. I hope it's some more Oakland niggas on that motherfucker so we
get
can go
a,
crazy.
Get you a vape. Get you an under vape. I was seeing the news where they is, like, they arrested you for smoking on the cruises.
Damn.
Yeah, so
I need
you
two
a,
vapes then.
Get you
That's a vape?
Yeah.
I need a big one like that. Yeah. How much them go for?
30.
Oh, for real?
Yeah.
Who got them?
Come
you?
Down the street.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I'm pull up when I leave.
Yeah, I need one.
P need one, too, because she be sweating me like a motherfucker. Can I get a vape? Nope.
Yeah, when you get some, you know?
Yeah. But I'm going to have some weed, though, nigga. Don't get it twisted.
Regardless.
Yeah, we going to make it. We going to figure it out. Maybe I can't smoke on the boat. Or I know last time when I went, like, damn near 28 years ago, nigga, with my mama, I waited till it was late and went upstairs.
They crack it down.
Oh, marijuana?
They doing a serious crackdown. It was on the news.
Oh, yeah, I don't want to go to jail in Mexico.
Yeah, that's what they was like. They arresting you for smoking because it was people smoking on the cruise. And you know how they blow it out of proportion.
Last time I went, bud, like before we even left, somebody blowing the hallway down, nigga. They hit their door so hard. I'm right next door to the nigga, so I'm like, damn, they finna jack us too. But they hit their room, nigga.
Yeah,
I think they actually stayed on the boat, like, because we didn't pull off, so they could have actually kicked them off. I think they actually stayed on the boat, but I think they might have took their weed or did some old punk shit.
Yeah, I was seeing that.
Yeah, I don't want to go to jail, period. But I for sure don't want to go to jail outside of Alameda County.
Yeah, you feel me?
Because you go, nigga, especially L.A. or Mexico. I don't want to, them the two areas where I don't want to go. Because them niggas going, they're going to try to do something to you just because you're from the town. I ain't got time for that shit. Let me put a burrito on you, Holmes.
Yeah,
we ain't gonna do that.
Shit puts back
right. What else you had going on this week though? A little bit, cuz you've been busy, my nigga.
We did the speed dating. No, that was the week before that.
How was that though? Did we talk about that last week?
It was cool. It was all right. Canary and them crazy. They crazy. That's
oh, it was her shit. That was their shit. Shout out to Canary and Andre and Nicole, Sugar and Spice, and everything nice.
They did that. This week was pretty much private. I did a going away party for my friend's friend.
Mm-hmm.
And, we rocked it all day.
Yeah, nigga, I see the weather is starting to pick up.
Come on, let's go. We outside tonight.
I don't like heat, bud. I don't like heat, for real. Nigga, my house hiding and hella shit, bud. Like, god damn, I don't like this shit. Nigga go to sleep mad. Like, man, some bullshit. Move, bitch.
Every fan on.
You don't want to touch. No, man, move, man. Get nigga ain't sleeping
me.
With no covers on or
say,
nothing.
Get off me.
Right, get off me, bitch. The Aloha Bar was jumping this Friday.
Oh, I got to show you the clips, bro. I don't know who Motorcycle Club it was or whatever they was. They came in there so deep. It was parading around the club. It was
Mexican?
It was going, yeah, it was everybody.
Oh, them was the mangoes.
It
nigga.
Was everybody.
The mangoes, they came to Oakland.
This whole weekend was real busy. Everywhere.
It was busy for you?
It was busy.
Yeah, it was busy, period, though. But it's hot. Niggas is outside. Yeah. Nigga, COVID is, well, I can't even say that, though, because niggas still catching it, so be careful.
Yeah, you got to be careful. That's what I was about to say, man. Everybody outside, you got to be careful, man. Cause
you got to watch niggas just coughing and shit.
Niggas coughing and sweating on you.
Right.
Nah, man.
See, I always sweat, though, so you can't use the sweat.
Nah, but you sweat on your own towel. So
yeah,
you
I got a fat nigga towel everywhere I go.
Wiping their hand
and then,
come on.
I told myself I was gonna actually stop giving people bumps or shaking their hands because people be nasty as fuck, but for real. Now I done seen some nasty shit.
And fellas, for real, fellas, my uncle taught me this though, for real. If you got any ounce of player in you, any kind of about yourself, clean your fingernails, man. Come on, y'all. Clean under your fingernails. Don't have that black line under your fingernails. Clean that out.
Yeah, I'll bite my shit off before I have dirty.
Soak them or something, man.
That's all it takes, nigga.
Clean your fingernails.
See, niggas don't know about pedicures or manicures, nigga. When you go to the place and get a manicure, all they do is put your hand in some soapy water for like 5 minutes.
I was.
Take the motherfuckers out. Your shit clean.
I passed my blunt. I was unloading. I passed my blunt, and I did not want it back.
Right.
Because the nails that grabbed it was like, oh, no.
Like,
what the fuck
kind of dirt is in there,
oh,
nigga?
No. How you don't feel that?
But niggas don't be giving a fuck. Like, for
come
real.
Come on, man.
I learned that from a woman a long time ago, but that's why I'm, like, real being on. I bite my shit off before I have dirty-ass nails.
Yeah, I keep my shit down to the nub, too, before I have dirty-ass nails.
And I have clean-ass shoes.
And like, I work, though. So, working ain't no excuse. Yeah. You clean your nails.
Yeah, you can. You can, definitely. But, see, that just lets you know that niggas don't take care of themselves like they should.
Nasty.
You know what I'm saying? I'm like, I'm finna go get my feet hit before I go to Mexico because I'm walking around that motherfucking sandals, bitch. What? Bitch,
I'm surprised
my feet look better than yours.
Something like that on the boat.
Yeah, I ain't gonna. Nah, nigga, they gonna want 8,000. 8,000 for a penny.
On the cruise.
Is like
it expensive
a
on the cruise? It ain't no deal?
But I don't know, but it's been a minute. I ain't been on a cruise. Like, literally, I was 21. I'm 49, so that was, 27 years ago? Yeah, so I don't know, but I'm figuring, like, that's a big-ass boat. I'm pretty sure it got a lot of shit going on there. I know I'm a gamble a little bit. But
they got the casino in there.
I'm looking forward to the shit, bro. Like, for real. Like, I'm looking forward
for
to
that.
It. I ain't took a I ain't had a vacation, especially a vacation this long, in a long time, blood. I ain't gonna even say, nigga. I don't know how long it's been since I had a vacation this long. Like, I'm literally off. I only work 2 more days this week. I get paid for the 4th. I get paid for the 4th. Paid for the 5th. The weekend is the 6th to 7th, and I got a vacation from the 7th through the 13th.
Oh, so you got like a 10-day?
10-day, come on,
man. Get down.
And when I come back home, a check will be there from the new job. Come on, look at God.
Come on.
Look at God. I ain't gonna even bullshit with the tongue because I was gonna start talking in tongue, but I ain't gonna play with God like that. That's some shit you gotta really know to be talking about. I ain't gonna do that. But yeah, God is good, man. God got me in a good place, man. Like, to the point where it, like, just helping people, helping myself at the same time, a better job, less drama. And just, you know what I'm saying, bringing funny to the people, man, and having this podcast and just pushing everything that I'm going, man.
Funny.
Yeah, and bringing the funny for sure, because everybody need that, you know what I'm saying? And once again, April 3rd, the Black Repertory Theater. Tickets are on sale now. Brown paper tickets, though, but I really want y'all to come to this comedy show because I take it serious when it comes to my productions, you know what I'm saying? And shout out to everybody that's put me on shows or shows that I didn't book or be with other people. But when it comes to my baby, like, this is my baby, man. That shit says TWO Presents. So that's my shit, you know what I'm saying? I can't have it no other way than to go hard. Like, this next month, I am going hard than a motherfucker. Even in Mexico, I'm going to be making posts. Get your tickets. Get your motherfucking tickets. But please get your tickets. Come support. And it's not even about me at the end of the day. It's about the comedians. It's about the Black Repertory Theater that's been around for hella years.
Hella years.
It's about the black businesses that I have vendoring. You know what I'm saying? For those people that don't know these people, you can actually network and taste their food or buy their merchandise and just show love to other people like yourselves. You know what I'm saying? You don't get this at the Coliseum. You don't get this at Tommy T's. And I'm not knocking neither one of those things. I mean, neither one of those places, but I'm just saying you don't get that type of love, black love, in one building. Except for a TWO show. I've seen people try to imitate and try to do it like me, copycat it and all this shit. That's fine. You know what I'm saying? As long as you helping somebody else. This shit ain't about just me at the end of the day. August 3rd is not just about me. It's about everybody that got something to do with that shit, including my DJ. You know what I'm saying? You know, you might want to buck the nigga. Hey, there you go. You know what I'm saying? So it's all about the network. That's one thing I've always did when it came to promoting comedy shows. You know what I'm saying? I try to help other people as well. Of course I want the bag. Of course I want to win. But at the same time, when I win and everybody else that's a part of something that I throw wins, man, that's a win-win situation. And it has people wanting to continue on fucking with you. I got a couple people, as soon as I say Bender, nigga, they automatically cash out because they already know, nigga, it's not going to be no, you're not fucking your money off. You're going to get yours. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, man, I'm excited about that. I'm excited for the vacation. I'm excited about the new job. Man, the new job is peaches and cream, but, like, it's peaches and cream. But I can't, man, come on, man. Like, it's always good to like where you work at, but when you love where you work at, or you just be like, ooh, nigga, this where I'm at now, this how much more I'm making, this one I ain't got to deal with, this what I can still be doing to help the community. It's like a win-win situation, man. So I'm very thankful. The more time that I spend there, I will be giving you guys that's watching more information on what I can do or what I can do to help somebody that needs help. But it's basically the same thing I'm doing at CalPEP. And I ain't taking nothing away from CalPEP. Shout out to CalPEP. I just left there when I left my job today. You know what I'm saying? And it's just I'm trying to put both organizations together. I'm trying to put the Peer Wellness Collective, that's where I'm at now, and CalPEP together for the things that they lacking on that we might have, and vice versa. You know what I'm saying? So I still want to be helping the people that are homeless, that need places to stay, that need hygiene kits, that need showers and whatever else, free IDs. You know what I'm saying? I got access on that. You know what I'm saying? You fill out the paperwork, and we give you a free ID. We don't give it to you, but you go to the DMV for it. You know what I'm saying? So it's basically paid for it. That shit costs $36. So that's helping a lot of motherfuckers, too. So I'm just basically trying to help everybody and anybody that I can, but you know what I'm saying? I ain't a preacher, but this is my calling. This is what God want me to do. You know what I'm saying? It's bigger than just the comedy part. The comedy part is always going to be there because that's what I've been doing for the last 13, 14 years. But this is my new journey. This is my new thing that I'm doing, is to try to help people. You know what I'm saying? And I'm working on something now where I'm trying to help the youth. So we're going to get into these juvenile halls, and we're going to pull up all black men to these hoods where we know niggas is having problems at, and like really try to find a solution or a way to help us stay alive, to help us stay out of jail and just live right, man. Like, for real, like, it's a lot of shit going on, and we ain't going to be able to take care of it overnight. But as long as it's people like me and once this team of people or these team of brothers that I get together that can help me or be the same, have the same kind of voice to help these people, man, that's what we trying to do. You know what I'm saying? Even with Mr. Fab, the incident that happened and this shit was very unfortunate because Fab didn't had functions for like the last damn near 20 years. You know what I'm saying? And never had no shootings. Nobody never ever got shot or killed or none of that shit. You know what I'm saying? So it's just like, you know, he's trying. You know what I'm saying? And I salute him for trying. But we need to, for the ones that's tired of this shit in these streets, that's born and raised in Oakland, California, we need to all come together, man, and the sisters too. I ain't taking nothing away from y'all, because some of you sisters need to talk to some of these young ladies. You know what I'm saying? Let them know it's bigger than sexy red and twerking your ass and fucking for $40 and all that shit. Y'all really need to start giving some of these sisters some game and letting them know that it's bigger than that at the end of the fucking day. And that's where I'm trying to go with that, blood. Like, you know what I'm saying? And it seemed like when it's people out here trying to do that, that's when they get knocked off. So I'm scared at the same time, but at the same time. No, for real, they take it. Look at the history. Look at the history of everybody that tried. They've been talking the same shit. They've been doing this same shit. Something happens to them. So I'm going to play my role the best that I can. I'm going to be on the lookout and be very observant and shit. But I definitely want to help people. Somebody calling us? Okay, but yeah, I definitely want to help the people, man. I definitely want to help the community. I've been away. I was in Sacramento for like almost 12 years. I moved back, and it's just been all town business ever since I came back, man. So, yeah, man, if anybody is with this movement, I don't know if y'all commenting, but I know y'all looking. So if y'all commenting in the chats, tell me something that I might not know, man. If y'all want to call in and say that y'all know an organization that's doing what I'm talking about, tap in with us, 510-563-7819, man. You had anything to do before the first commercial break? You had anything to say, any plug or anything? Anything spectacular happened since last week?
Nah, we on it. Tonight, we outside. Artist Retreat.
Artist Retreat been going on. How long? How many years?
This going on, we about 3.5 years in.
3.5 years, big. That's big. Yeah. Salute to everybody that supports the Artist Retreat, as well as Uncle Phil and my nigga Big Twice, and everybody, like the vendors, everybody. The door lady, what's her name?
Miss Fudge. What's up, Miss Fudge?
Shout out to Miss Fudge. I'm sorry for not remembering your name.
And we got Cognac Confessionals in the building.
Cognac
with
Confessionals, stay in the building. Hello. Check his podcast out every Monday from 6 until, I believe, like 8 o'clock. You can go to Facebook and find it. Cognac, like the drink, Confessionals. Or you can check it out on YouTube, man. And pull up. Just hear what he got to say. The brother speaks a lot of knowledge. He has a lot of guests on there like I be having. And it's a real good show. You know what I'm saying? We got to start supporting our own before y'all start supporting Club Shay Shay and the Drinking Champs and all that shit. They got their numbers, nigga. Can we get our numbers up one time?
You feel me?
You know what I'm saying? I don't get paid for this shit. I do this shit for the love and for the love of the people. And because a little bit, got the motherfucking spaceship.
What?
But real talk. I seen some shit happen in Canada yesterday or the day before with Rick Ross and OVO gang, the OVO gang. That's on the internet right now. Yeah, they put hands on. I think Rick Ross got took off on in the video I seen, and then they beat the shit out of his security guard, which was a big nigga. And the niggas that beat him up was like 120, but they was beating his ass.
Oh wow.
Yeah, I wish I would have sent you that clip. That's going around right now. You know what I'm saying? So I'm like, damn, but this nigga go out there and play not like us in Canada. The fuck is wrong with you, nigga? This nigga play not like us in Canada. Nigga, they went hamburger.
That ain't even his song. Why you even in that business?
Because niggas is talking that shit.
That don't make no sense. That don't make no sense.
But yeah, they got that work, and it's televised on hella streams. So
hey, but you know what I do want to say about that, though? Shouts out to DJ Mustard. That man beat getting played everywhere. I don't care what version you like. You feel me?
Nigga, they play that shit in church.
Man, Taraji P even got it.
Oh, she killed that. She killed that. I ain't even watched the BET Awards, but she killed.
I watched that clip, though.
Yeah, I watched that clip a few times. She beat their ass.
Sometimes you just got to pop out.
Right. That's it. That's it. For real. But, yeah, he got a. Yeah, OVO was not OV Hoes against Rick Ross. They get that boy the business. They get that nigga the business, but not more of him, but his security guard. And he had big niggas. And the way they was kicking that nigga all in the face and punching him while he was down, and he was like one of them niggas like, fuck it, I'm going to take it. Go ahead and do what y'all do. But they was beating his ass, bud. And I'm like, damn, that's fucked up. They beat that boy like that. But, yeah, that happened. Ain't really nothing, no bullshit really happened in the town, but these niggas is crazy than a motherfucker. And it was a high speed down my street the other day. And I don't know why the fuck the second highway patrol came like 45 seconds later. I was like, nigga, he gone.
Hella late.
I'm talking about this nigga came down my street going like at least 100, nigga. And we heard it coming, so I got up. I'm sitting down, but I get up. I'm like, what the fuck? Because you hear the highway patrol behind me, but you hear this nigga truck blasting. Boom! Nigga, I open the door. This nigga passed right by my house. Boom! Then the highway patrol get behind this nigga. He a little late. I'm like, nah, y'all ain't going to make this nigga. This nigga hitting speed. This nigga hitting speed bumps. He hitting speed bumps now, nigga. But he like 3 blocks away. And then hit the corner. Then you see another highway patrol. Nigga, I got in the street and was like, code 4.
They were code 4.
Yeah, it's over. Look, these motherfuckers, like, be careful when y'all be out in these streets driving. And, nigga, just because your light is green don't mean that nobody running that red. Like,
hey, Oakland 6 second rule.
Man, on my mama. Like, you have to, bud.
Count six before you put the gas.
Yeah, for real. You thinking it's pretty, nigga, and fuck around and nigga be all in your windshield. So please drive safe. If you ain't got insurance on your car, please get so, or you gonna take a loss if somebody bap your shit. Cause nowadays, these niggas is hitting and running. They not sticking around and seeing, oh, are you okay? Hell no. Nah. But the bitch is doing it too.
Right.
They doing it more. The ladies. I'ma keep it respectful. But you bitches is doing it too.
Right,
ain't no lady pulled off.
Ain't no lady pulled off.
These bitches has been in the cars with these niggas that been doing this shit for years, and they driving just like them. On my mama, they doing everything. And don't think that a bitch a punk, she'll get out of her car and shoot your shit up. Be safe out here, ladies and gentlemen. That's all I'm asking. I'm going to run down the little weekly thing that we got at Bay Life Radio. Monday through Friday, man, from 10 to noon, you can catch the morning show. Also on Monday from noon to 2 p.m., Sipping Tea with Sugar and Spice, followed by Mad Mondays from 5 to 7. Then on Tuesdays from noon to 2 p.m., we got DJ X1 in the mix, followed by same day, 2 p.m. to 4, DJ Hyphy in the mix. So y'all can tap in and check them out. Fridays from 10 a.m. to noon, we got the DJ Squaropolis, the square one, in the mix, man. So he going to keep your Friday lit. It's going down for sure. Then we got a little Big Cuz doing something that's a little different. You know what I'm saying? But it's needed. You know what I'm saying? At the end of the week, we got from 10 a.m. to noon the Sunday Praise Mix by DJ Igor Beats. And then you can catch him the same hour at Sweet Fingers getting it in as well. Playing, boy, he had me in there off Bob Marley. Nigga, I almost grew dreads. Like, I was in there like this.
I was on a Bob Marley.
Like, nigga, I'm dancing to every song. No, I know most of them, but it was a couple of them I didn't know. And nigga, I was like, who's that, Bob Marley? He was like, yeah. I was like, well, shit, keep slapping that shit.
Catalog.
Yeah, that's a nice little something to go to, you know what I'm saying, on Sundays, man. So please support all these businesses and places that we telling y'all about. And just show your love, man. You can tell them, DJ Igor Beast and Whiteout sent you. If we ain't working them, just tell them that Bay Life Radio sent you, man, and it's definitely appreciated. Without further ado, we're going to go to a commercial break right now, and we'll be back with our co-host for the day. This is Mad Mondays. Thank y'all for tuning in.
I used to shoot all my videos with
Hooker Boy.
Shouts out to T-Wings.
Man, it's a cold game. I seen Mickey Renner, but can't run from the pain. Man, I'm tired of shedding tears, man. I'm all cried out. Turn an L into a W. Do I take a different route? Put a lot in the wrong plan, thinking I'm a win. Father, wherever I'm wrong, forgive me for my sins. Man, the devil's still trying, but I'm a man. I wonder why. In position where I have to make a decision or die. Telling you the first that's quick to try and test me. Riding dirty, but once hoping they don't arrest. Taking 50-50 chances, but I gotta make a move. I stay high to keep from stress. Hope is pure, putting me in a good mood.
Man. Don't this shit be like this, though.
Too much talking to myself got me answering my own questions. Snakes in the grass, boy, you ain't learned your lesson. Stuck deep in thoughts, you can see it across my face. Right now is not the time. Man. Know the place. I can't stand for no man to sit up and try to use me. That four-letter word you usually abuse me.
Please stop telling me shit to try to confuse me. My patience is gone, I'm real short, what a fuse be. End of the day, all I seem to do is choose me. How do you seem to trust when you're around enemies? And there's not too many left, all the real ones gone.
When I give all this shit up,
if you just pick up your phone.
Man, I miss you, mama.
Rest in peace. Pops. Moms. Cousins. Uncles. Aunties. Grandparents. Friends. Somebody I knew.
I can make a whole lot of shit crumble, bro.
Skip that nigga over the bench.
Word on the street is this nigga PJ riding around telling motherfuckers I done killed Corey. My nigga. You feel what I'm saying?
Okay.
I need you to take care of PJ.
I don't know, be playing, man. Tell him, you know, we're trying to make something happen, though. So, nigga, I ain't got too much time to be waiting on.
I'm gonna get the white bitch on it.
Oh, like this.
White bitch I took from Joe.
See, that's the shit I be talking about, man. It's what? Always something bigger with your plan.
But the bitch don't know me.
Really had to tell you though, right? That nigga PJ ain't cool, bro.
Oh, what you doing?
That nigga out here selling that fake shit, that stepped on shit, and he saying he getting it from us.
Lights out. Paying the fucking price, bitch.
A hype train, put it to the star show.
On my mama, they say I go. On my mama, they say I go.
Hey, look, baby like nigga, he be showing hella love. I made a saucy little slapper on the way to the club. When I hop up on the bar, I see the turf dancers. Yeah, I'm ready from the bay like a Black Panther, yeah. We got hella talent in the bay, and we ain't gonna let no hate get up in the way. Get about your feelings and get up off your world. Speaking of rest, I see something walking past.
You at Lake Merritt the other day, you passed me by. On mama's, you was saucy, I could tell. You ain't shy. Did you go to Skyline High, or was it Castlemont? She said she just got back in town, she traveled around a lot. She moved to Antioch, cause the rent hella high. Yeah, living in the Bay, you is a G if you survive. On mama, something special about community. We're tired of the acting.
Keep it real,
cause all I'm really want is something original.
I took a hype train, put up to the star show.
On my mama, they say I go. On my mama, they say I go.
Cause all I'm Britney want is something original. A
little
old school down, mixed with ain't no smooth flow. My name is Love, my runner West Side. I took a hype train, put up to the star show.
On my mama, they say I go. On my mama, they say I go.
I'll be forgetting. It's been a minute. Hey, is that song new? Who was that one more time for the people?
That's Love More.
Love More. Shout out to
West
my nigga.
West Oakland.
West Oakland. Shout out to the West. Shout out to the East. Shout out to the North. Shout out to South Oakland. It is a South Oakland.
Wait.
Hagenberger.
That was a trick yesterday when somebody said.
Talking to the mic so the people can hear you.
Somebody said to ask if you ask somebody from the town where it's South Oakland and they tell you where it's at, you know they not from the town.
No, you know they from the town.
There is no South Oakland.
It is a South Oakland.
There is no South Oakland.
You Google it, it's going to give you a fucking address. Real talking, it ain't Alameda. It's by the airport.
Really?
Hell fucking yeah. I did it a long time ago. I did. Am I lying a little bit, cuz? No, for real.
So we got North Oakland.
But niggas ain't claiming that
because
ain't nobody staying there.
But
like, don't nobody stay by the airport.
North Oakland way in the 50s. Mm-hmm. East Oakland is all the rest. That's not West Oakland.
Right.
And South Oakland where? I'm gonna have to look for a longitude latitude.
Yeah, we'll definitely googling on a commercial break.
Yeah, let's do that.
We'll let you know that for sure. But welcome back. This is Mad Mondays. I'm your host Whiteout, aka Two. And without further ado, my co-host, and you've seen her. She's like the only person that really wants to come and co-host with me and shit. She wants to go. I was like, can I go host? I'm like, yeah, for sure. Co-hosts are good every once in a while. And then you have your you have things going on too, so it's always good to bring you so you can show. I mean, present the network and the things that you have going on in your life as well. So, first of all, I want to say thank you for coming. I definitely appreciate you.
You're welcome. But since you made it like I hound you.
No, not at all. But you do tap in and be like, nigga, I can't get on the show no more. You ain't do. Okay,
I do.
Yeah.
I do. We not gonna cap.
But I mean, you know what? We could probably work on getting you a show if you want to do that.
I do.
Okay, we'll talk about it later. Without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, all the way from Oakland, California, please give it up for Miss Ayana. And I always fuck her name up because it's some other shit, and I don't call her that. So.
Thank you.
Don't leave me hanging, nigga.
Thank you.
bling on the shit. Okay, so Ayana, Miss Ayana, how you doing? Thank you for coming.
Good. Thank you for having
me. So what is it again?
It's Yana Smiles.
Yana Smiles One.
That's it.
Yana Smiles One.
Yeah, I'm gonna write that shit down next time. When it's old and you never change it, and you don't like update or change the name or anything like that.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's a brand, like, yeah, it's locked in.
Yeah,
it's locked in.
It's locked in.
Yeah, Miss Ayana, I definitely appreciate you sliding through. To tap in with me. One of my guests, I only had one, but he's going to be a little late, but he's on his way. So thank you. I appreciate that.
Thank you for having
Real
me
talk. So again. Since the last time you've been here, what's been going on with you?
Man, I do the same work you do. The nice promotion that you just got. Thank you for joining us in the community of helping everybody, having more resources to do more great things. You was already doing phenomenal work, and now you just got to expound a little bit. And
expound, is that
further.
A word?
That's a word.
Okay, I figured that because you went to college.
Oh, he gonna try it. But no.
Was you in the first time? Was you in any of that?
No.
You didn't fuck around? What was that? A seniority?
A sorority.
See? Ooh. Seniority.
Look.
You know, nigga, I got my GED in Santa Rita, so don't even.
But he's helping the community.
I am helping the community.
That's all that matters. You don't have to be hooked on phonics for that.
I be watching that shit on TV though. If I would have went to college, I definitely would have probably been. I would have been the cats in the red.
No, you wouldn't have.
I would have.
No, you wouldn't.
I wouldn't have been the. I would have been them niggas.
Yes,
them cool niggas with the shoulders. They be doing.
Wasn't that cool?
Man, them niggas. That shit look clean
as
fuck.
Is cool.
Yeah.
They dance is cool. You'd have been a cute. Not taking anything away from the Kappas, but I'm just gonna
say, niggas is raw though.
Being
they
born and
with
raised
dance
in
shit,
Oakland,
though.
You are definitely a Q, not a Kappa.
Damn,
not a Kappa.
That's fucked up.
Yeah,
cause them niggas is raw. I like them
That's
niggas.
That's Alameda.
That's South Oakland.
South Oakland. No, deep South Oakland.
I know. I be watching that shit, be trying to learn. I'm like, nigga, see me doing that shit out in public and probably jump me because they're like, nigga, you ain't a part of this shit.
It is. You can get in trouble and clown big time.
I wish a nigga would run up on me like they did that nigga. What movie was that? No, the movie.
No, this really happened.
No, the movie. The movie with Columbus Short when he walked through the
drumline. Yeah.
No, that wasn't drumline. Stomp the yard.
Something.
Remember
okay,
he
right.
walked through them niggas and niggas like, hold on, don't get fucked up.
But no, it was a lady that was imitating being an AKA. She was out there trying to do the moves with them, and she was fucking it up. And one of the real ones came out there, grabbed her, and was like a real chokehold pull up out of there. Like, don't play with it.
Yeah, don't play with it, bitch. If you're going to do it, you better do it right.
But not only that,
not only that, you pay big money. You pay big money to be a part of that, and you pay annual dues.
Right.
So yeah, they
that's like that's stuff. Like crip walking, and you ain't really a crip.
And you gotta pay to be a crip.
What you mean?
No, I'm saying if it's oh, like right, right, right. being yeah, a crip, yeah, if you yeah. had to pay to be one, you actually got an invoice.
I think that shit cute though. Sweet. Silly.
Not until you're hearing it all shit. Day. Not until you're hearing it all day, on right, campus. Right. So you'll be like, look.
Because what college you went to?
Several. But Morris Brown.
Okay,
Clark.
That's the one you claim, though.
I paid you said tuition several. To all of
you went to
so
Laney, too?
No. No. But I went to.
See, I got my shit right. Then I went to Morehouse. But I started at Contra Costa County.
No, I went to Morris Brown, Clark. Houston Tillotson, see, Sac State.
Damn, you yeah. got around.
I did.
And how many years?
Holy Names, huh?
How many 16. Years?
16.
You did 16 years of college? God damn. How many bachelors you got?
Two.
Yeah.
That's
what's up. So back to your the networking and shit you doing, because we was talking off air right. and you got mad. Because
you was like, the fellas need to come through and change some things, but it's some things that these women need to get together too, because it's
see, I wasn't even talking, I was talking about the part where you was like, how nigga get go to class, do all this for construction, and then only get one check.
Yeah, like what is quit. The? It's like running off on the plug.
Right.
Like you go to work, you get one check, and then you just quit. You don't come back no more. Like you MIA. What can you do with that one check?
Right.
Because wherever you go to buy something, they ask you for your work history.
Talking to the
you
mic.
You have to have a work history, facts. People. And it's usually 5+ years. They're really looking for 10+. So if you work 1 week and two right. weeks, it really doesn't count as the same time frame to qualify you for the things that you might want to obtain. Just a hint. Just saying.
So back to your job. Like, can we talk about your job and what you do?
Yes.
Do you have a class coming up soon?
I have a cohort 24 coming up August 12th. We are still in District 10 in Hunters Point, Bayview area of San Francisco. The company that I work for, the nonprofit agency, is a black agency called YCD, Young Community Developers. We are just out here trying to get, you know, young people of color into a career or a job. You know what I mean? We're not forcing careers on anyone. We're keeping it open to show you how to go about doing it if that's what you're trying to do.
Gotcha.
Now, if you are trying to just get a check, we can line you up with that too. But we're trying to change the mentality of living check to check, because really that's a dead end.
Right.
And you can't really have any ownership. And that's not for everybody. So I'm not going to make it like, oh, that's the only thing that, you know, acquires you to success is mm-hmm. owning something.
Right.
But you want to be able in this life to say that something belongs to you. Mm-hmm. Besides just your person.
Yeah, what's the shit called? Generational wealth.
Generational wealth. And you want to be able to work smarter, not harder.
Facts.
You don't want to sit up here and do bad. I mean, like, okay, they talk about how our people.
OG.
They talk about how our people overcame slavery or whatnot. Do you think that that was something that they opted to say? Well, you know, because that was for show money, we going to go back to that. Because, you know, right. the sun and everything, you know, was always cool with us. Mm-hmm. We dark anyway. Like, you know, that wasn't a favorable environment to mm-hmm. work in. So
right.
yeah, you want to be able to do something right. that's better, you know, for you and your kids, to where you or not even you and your kids, just your family, period. It don't have to be your children. A lot of us now are being responsible for somebody else's children because they weren't able to do it, and we were able to step in and pick up the pieces. You know what I mean? So a lot of these kids ain't our biological kids, but we loving them and taking care of them the same.
Nigga, how you bring a lighter that don't even work? Yeah. That motherfucker ain't got no.
It was upside down.
Let me see your
lighter.
What the fuck? I didn't mean to cut you off like that though. But no, talk your shit though, because it's not just for it's not just for young men too. You helping young women too, right?
Women too.
Okay.
it's for young women too. You know, it's like we don't want to just, you know, be one check away from poverty and homelessness and all that other stuff. No, it was unrealistic for society to have us set up to move into a place and have three times the rent. Like, you buying a house, you gotta have three times the mortgage in the bank, plus be ready for a rainy day and this, that, and the third. Who making that much when the average income is $58,000 a year out here?
Ooh, I'm making more than that now.
You better know it. But just think about those.
But for
that
the people
don't.
That's not, though, facts.
You know what
no,
I'm
real
saying?
Talk.
There's 12 months in
I ain't
a
bragging.
Year.
I'm just blessed. I'm sorry.
There's y'all. 12 months in a year, people. If you only making $12,000, $24,000 a year, you're making $2,000 a month. Do you realize how much money that is? That's pennies for what it costs to live.
Yeah.
And if you able to survive under that, man, you know something that you should be teaching everybody else. Because it's hard out here. And it's hard to not be living check to check, even when you are blessed enough to make $75,000, $80,000.
Right.
You still waiting on your next check. Thanks. To take care of things that you need to take care of and pay your bills. Because you can't pay them otherwise. So I'm just saying, maybe instead of all these, like, and nothing against the programs that we have out here that are providing resources for people to do, you know, things for themselves and get them started and get their feet wet and get them off the ground. But maybe we should stop all this handing out, all this handing out, and let's try to change the mentality. Because the way you think got a lot to do with the decisions you make.
Come on, talk on it. Talk on
that shit.
A lot
of people out here quick to say, fuck it. Fuck it.
Yeah.
They say fuck it before the shit even really get hard.
Because they don't have patience.
No patience, no discipline, no tenacity.
But you have to learn that.
And that's what I'm saying. Yeah. Instead of giving people all this stuff, like, let me give you this. Let me give you a job. Let me give you a handout. Let me give you back rent. Let me give you this, give you that. Okay, all these people that's getting these handouts are now being entitled.
Facts.
They're now being
dependent. Yeah, they're comfortable with
and
that.
And it's stagnating them because the mentality never grows. If you can't think outside the box, you're going to stay in the box.
Facts. Talk your shit.
And I'm just, like, tired of the game of word of mouth telling people, oh, go down there and get that money. Go down there and tell them this and you can get this. Tell them this and they'll help you with that. If you say this, you can really get this. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's now to where the young people are scamming, you know, these programs and stuff, to where the programs are now failing. Mm-hmm. All these nonprofits that are losing money, they're not losing money because everybody there is greedy and everybody there is taking everything. That's not it. It's the ones that you're trying to help that's misappropriating the system, misappropriating the funds, and telling other people how to do it to where it turns into a ring of misappropriation. So you got this one person that's trying to help somebody that now it's turned into you've used them and you've manipulated their position to where they no longer have it because they was trying to help your ass.
Right, yeah.
And your ass trying to be slick. Everybody's always trying to be slick and one up instead of being like, you know what? I needed this. I got on my feet. Now let me take it from here and start this alley-oop on my own. Because this ball still got to get in the motherfucking hole.
Man, come on. The phone lines are open, 563-7819. Yeah, let's talk about this shit.
You know, and people make it like it's weed and alcohol. It's more than that. It's the food we eating. It's the conversations that we having, it's the music we listening to. If you know all the words to Sexy Red at 45, your ass got a problem. if you can quote the lyrics of the Migos and all this stuff and you're in your mid-40s, you got a fucking problem. I understand knowing the hook.
Right.
But when you know word for word, you're more than just a music advocate.
Right.
You got hella free time.
Too much.
Because my thought process with work and family and everything else won't give me the bandwidth to learn a rap song from start to finish.
Especially without
in 2024.
Getting paid.
You did?
You ain't getting no money
I'm
for it.
I'm studying
like
this
fuck.
Shit?
Right.
Oh, absolutely not. That's an oxymoron.
Hello.
I'm not doing that. So, again, it's the mentality. You know, it's the way you think. And it's what you think of yourself. I see so much self-hate. I see so much self-hate with people that dress hella fly. They dress so nice. They look so good. But they hate themselves because the way they talk to people, the way you treat people. You know what I'm saying? Like, all of that is a reflection of self-loathing. And you don't even know it. Like, I walk around with humor all day. I may not even be funny, according to you, but you
according
said
to
I,
who?
You said I wasn't funny.
What the fuck,
no,
man?
No, because then he said I wasn't funny.
No, I'm just kidding.
I'm just kidding. No, but I walk around with humor because I'm sorry, because I'm at peace.
Right.
I have peace in my life.
Right.
I have quiet. I have steel. I have sanity. I don't have stress. I'm not saying that life don't be lifing,
yeah,
but
for sure
I don't have drama. I don't have any of that. And I haven't had that for years, at least a decade.
But that didn't happen overnight.
It didn't happen overnight.
Right.
I was wild out here in these streets in
was
the beginning
you?
In the 90s, in the 80s maybe. I don't know. Maybe I was too young for the 80s. Let's
you
not take it too far.
Yeah.
But we'll
you
say the 90s. Well, it's 89 into 90s. I gave it a run. But what I'm
you
saying.
Was starting?
Nah, but you know.
You was in the streets though.
Okay, so let's say this. We're gonna put this on the mic today. We gonna leave this R. Kelly shit alone. The nastiness, I'm with it. All the way, he should be in jail. But the age difference, Oakland, y'all not gonna play with me. Cause I was there and I seen it. All these old niggas was picking up girls in high school. Out of pocket. But did we feel they was out of pocket? We didn't complain. We was a part of the shit. We was hiding it from our people and our parents.
No,
and,
go ahead. I'm sorry.
We
ahead.
Was hiding it. So that means we were in compliance.
Right.
We did not feel abused or any of those things to those that weren't. Let me say that.
But even if you was doing that shit, you knew it wasn't right. That's why you didn't tell
nobody.
No. You knew it wasn't right. That's
okay.
Why you kept it a secret.
Yeah. Okay.
You know what
but
I'm saying?
Some,
but the world is, too sensitive.
Knew.
It's too emotional.
But somebody
so
in your camp knew that allowed it.
Yeah, but.
But that's all I'm
niggas
saying.
Niggas weren't telling like that.
If
was
one
kids
auntie,
telling
wait, no,
was,
no, no,
hold
no,
on.
No.
Was kids
no.
telling on their parents calling CPS back then,
hell
nigga?
Hell no. But let's say this. If
did you want to do it if you knew about it?
If
hell
you, if,
yeah.
If a young girl was messing with an older boy and her mother didn't know, if one of her aunties knew.
She was probably fucking the nigga
that's
too.
No, not at all. What I'm saying is okaying it, giving her the okay.
Right, because she was doing that type. She was doing
maybe
that type of shit.
Maybe the auntie was
yeah,
too at
yeah.
some point.
She was a toss-up.
I ain't gonna go that far.
You remember them?
Yeah.
Okay.
But what I'm
if we going back there, we gotta talk about it.
But that's not it. We just saying you have fast aunties that understand
that was
fast
fucking.
Nieces.
Yep.
And we talking about a 20-year age difference, so they're completely grown. They're not no teenager influencing a child. This is like I understand that you just a little ahead of your time and whatever you doing, you wanna do what you're doing. You ain't being forced. That's all I'm saying. Your auntie is the one who scales if this is appropriate, if this is something you want to do or not. You know what I'm saying? And a lot of us back then, we wanted to do what we was doing because we did our chores and our homework before we went to go do that shit. So, yeah, you planned it. It was strategic. It was thought out. It was all of that played a part into it. That's all I'm saying. So,
y'all
yeah,
was just nasty.
We was bad. At one point,
fucking.
We were bad.
I know
but,
13-year-old girls that
okay,
had
no,
babies.
I ain't talking about that. I'm talking about 16, 17.
Man, fuck that. We talking about what we talking about.
No,
I know
I'm
young
saying,
girls that was 13 years old that had babies.
Okay, but I'm saying
they
from,
were fucking.
From my experience, I'm
the
talking
first time
about
I got
16,
some pussy
17.
At 13 years old,
okay,
she was older than me and gave it to me.
So I wasn't going to say no.
See, and that's what I'm saying. The
but that bitch
standard.
Wasn't no R. Kelly, though.
But that's the double standard.
No,
that's the double
standard. She wasn't even that older than me. She was probably like a couple years older. I think like maybe 16, 17. I was 13.
Statutory rape is what that is.
She was under 18.
Still, you took advantage of a minor. She didn't take advantage of me. That's still statutory. Okay, see that again. You was in compliance.
Yeah,
you
we
wanted
started kissing
it.
And my dick got hard.
So
I pulled it out.
So you understand what I'm saying,
Lil,
because like, that when both parties are in compliance,
on,
whether
no.
they're right or wrong,
no, but
whether they're right or
put
wrong,
put your mic on, nigga.
They think, in their minds, they think they're right, so they're doing what they want to do,
but,
and they're willing to suffer the consequences.
But it wasn't no young niggas 13 years old or in high school getting picked up by no older bitches.
Yes, it was.
Yes, it was.
Not like that.
Not.
Man, they was.
It was
saying,
though.
Man,
It wasn't hell of them.
If it was, 10 dudes, it was probably two girls.
Nigga, that's 20%.
Because girls didn't really have their own car like that. To you know what I mean?
No, I'm talking about just the
high school.
I'm talking about the age, though.
But let's talk
the
about
age.
The young boys who was fucking with girls and their mamas. Because I knew a couple of them.
Salute to you niggas.
I knew a couple of them.
I didn't get a chance to do that one.
I knew a couple of them that was, they was fucking the broad. They
and
was
the
staying
mama.
At the broad house. The daddy was on some sucker shit, and the nigga was playing on that and was fucking the mama and the daughter. I knew a couple of those situations.
Salute to them niggas, because that was real. That was some real B.I. right there, man. God damn. Is that what they was doing?
No.
Nigga, that sound like a Tubi movie, nigga. Some shit I seen on Tubi, my nigga. OG, what?
Listen, a lot of things used to go on back in the day that we didn't talk about out loud. That's all I'm saying. Because
people wasn't talking. The world is talking now.
They was talking. They just was talking to the right people that knew how to shut the fuck up. They wasn't selling stories. They wasn't going nowhere saying, hey, man, you know what? If you give me this, I could tell you about this. I bet you didn't know this, and you could publicize it and get paid off of it, and I'll give you these pictures, and you could do this and do that with it. All this old shit coming back, motherfuckers digging through their old shoe boxes, getting these pictures of these broads in puffy studios in the 90s and shit. Who the fuck kept Polaroids like that?
A lot of people.
Somebody that got... Okay,
no,
let's talk about who got
Polaroids.
Niggas that went to jail. Niggas that who mamas used to go to the VI and the and
oh,
and,
ain't that a bitch?
All those
my mama ain't never
that,
been to the VI.
That,
you got me fucked
had
up.
That wicker chair.
Mama's
that wicker chair was on Polaroid.
Was that destroyed? Was that the straw?
Yes,
the straw.
The straw wicker chair was on everybody Polaroids, and in the picture pose down on the ground where the two niggas is doing like this. With the arm.
My mama didn't go to the VI. She went to Silks.
Okay, either way. Sweet Jimmy's all in places had the wicker chair.
Yeah,
all
they did. Yeah.
Sweet
all
Jimmy's.
Right. All the motherfuckers. All
that's
right.
All
Tyrone.
I'm
the
saying.
After hours.
Right.
Broadway.
Right.
One stop.
Right.
Nigga, my mama had one in her house, nigga. My mama had one of them chairs in the house,
right?
Nigga. On my mama, nigga. Shout out to my mama. I'll see you in a minute.
AMPM had one. I'm just saying.
Right.
It was getting real raunchy back in the night.
How the fuck we started talking about thoughts and shit?
Because we're just talking about the mentality having to change. You know, the old, what you do when you're young, it does matter. You can it's okay to have a careless, reckless moment, but you can't live like nowadays. It's like, oh, I'm young, so I'm just wild and I'm free. Okay, but you can't be your whole 20s like that.
It's hella bitches out here that did that.
And that's why they fucked up now with a fucking 300 credit score at 45.
Fuck. I didn't even think your credit score could be that low. God damn.
It can.
300?
Listen,
Listen, we fix.
I'm doing good for myself.
We also help people fix their credit at YCB.
Oh, I just met one. I bet you my shit be 800 in a minute.
Already there. All I'm saying is, you know, the mentality has to change. At this age, you know, if you look back to where our parents were when they were our age, they were way more stable than we are.
Facts.
They were way more stable.
But they, I mean,
they, cause they,
but where they get it from?
Because they had their shit together.
No, but where even they get it from? They, no.
Even if there was any type of substance abuse or any of that shit, they learned how to be responsible so early.
Right.
To get it, to go to school, graduate, get a job, save your money, pension, army, whatever, whatever,
but
whatever.
Where they get that from? No, they got that from home.
So again,
they got that from home.
Again.
They got that from home. So you didn't say that, though, but they got that from home.
I was saying about the mentality being
of the,
different.
The parent. Okay, got you.
And I said, even though nowadays we're not just responsible for our biological children, we're raising other children
that
don't belong to
Real
us.
Real talk.
And you have to love them the same. That's what I was going to complete that statement with saying.
You tried to.
If you
wasn't finna say that.
If you're responsible for somebody's kid. No, for real. If you take them in, you know, motherfuckers take in with the sex trafficking, the human trafficking, all the shit going on. That lets you know that there's no substance to life. It's just it's a dollar amount. So if you take in somebody's child and you're worried about the foster check or whatever, and you don't just take them in and incorporate them into your family as one of yours, you look at that state money as a separate entity to do for this child, you're fucked up.
And it's a lot of people doing that.
And it's a hell. Did you see the goddamn white couple that got locked up for the damn kids being in the shed? And she kept them in there. And she, the white woman told the judge that they liked it in there. No running water, no toilets, none of that stuff. It was like 5 kids in there from ages 16 down, black kids. She was adopting these kids and turning them into slaves, keeping them as slaves in a tool shed behind her house. The neighbors had been calling the police. They had been calling the police, but they didn't have reasonable substance to come out there and check.
Right.
And when they finally did, when they saw one of the kids going out to the shed and had the police come out there and they discovered this, the man and the woman are in jail right now.
Well, good for them.
So I'm just saying, it's been going on for too long.
Yeah, no, and it's real shit. And I want to piggyback on that right quick because we was talking about it. But I just went to a peer, like a peer meeting. Mm-hmm. So basically a young lady, she invited like all the organizations. A lot of organizations came to it and she had 5 speakers. It was 5 speakers. It was 3 ladies and 1 dude. It was 2 black ladies, a white lady, and a Filipino lady, and a black brother. And everybody told their story. But when it came down, and it was the last person was to talk was a Filipino girl. And she told her story, but and she said at 3 years old that her father used to have sex with her. And when she told me, she cried a few times during this shit. Like, don't get it twisted. Like, she cried. She broke down. This was our first time talking. But she's telling her story as a peer because that's what, you know what I'm saying, that's what they were supposed to do is basically tell their story and basically tell you how they help people. You know what I'm saying? You have to be a peer in order to help somebody. Mm-hmm. Like, that's where we at now with this shit. Mm-hmm. Fuck knowing a book and studying that shit and knowing what the fuck it is. It's you got to have motherfuckers that had that experience.
Yeah.
So when they talking to you, they can understand you or you got questions for them or can talk to them like y'all talking instead of a motherfucker asking you questions. Well, why did you do that? Mm-hmm. Or why did you? Mm-hmm. And the motherfucker looking at you like, man, what the fuck? And don't want to do that.
3.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And I'm not even saying the same color, but it works when you're the same race. You know what I'm saying? It helps. Yeah. But that's where we've come down to. Like, that book shit, that shit played out in the world we're living in now. You know what I'm saying? To extinct. Now,
to a certain
degree. But still, okay,
because
but a person, okay, so look.
Some things go a little beyond, you know, empathy.
Just the hood.
Some things you got to just know the right protocol.
Right, okay, now I'm saying if a person that was a peer knew everything that a person with book smart had, you would listen to the person that was a peer They had the same book smart.
Absolutely.
That's what I'm saying. That's
absolutely.
What I'm saying.
Okay.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. And motherfuckers got to, like, really understand that shit. And the more I fuck with this shit, I'll be like, well, these niggas ain't finna. And before I got there, it wasn't no men there. You know what I'm saying? It was women. So they kept the shit closed. Now I work there, they starting to open the door, and a man is seeing another man and respecting that fact. Mm-hmm. I'm right there across the street from the Black Rep. You probably know some of them niggas is right there. Next to the little thing, that's where I'm at. Yeah, the drop-in. I'm in the drop-in center. So I know some of them niggas out there, but it's just the, I believe in giving you respect.
You see some niggas I know often.
Oh, yeah, for real. Them niggas be out there every day, too.
Yeah, yeah.
And somebody just died, so they had the funeral today, so they was finna start turning up when I left. And I'm glad that I was out of there before that, because I already knew what it was. But it's just like, you gotta know motherfuckers. Like, that white person can't come in there
right.
and be trying to have these niggas calm down when they already turned up or on some bullshit. It's not gonna happen because of some shit you read. That shit ain't gonna work. Mm-hmm. You might fuck around and get robbed or beat the fuck up.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Like, on some real shit. Like, nigga, we ain't trying to hear that shit.
Right.
That's the first thing a motherfucker that's up here is going to say to a motherfucker. Especially if you high or your mental is fucked up or some old weird-ass shit.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
Nigga, I ain't trying to hear that shit.
But let me say this.
The phone lines are open. 563-7819. I'm sorry.
Oh, 510-563-7819.
Yeah, yeah. Let's get some people talking, man. Are they commenting?
It takes more than just book smarts, for sure. Because my grandmother used to say all the time, that's an educated fool.
Right.
You have to have common sense, too.
I
don't give a fuck where you at, who you are, and what you're doing.
Mm-hmm.
You have to have instinct.
Mm-hmm.
And do you know what your instinct is? Your instinct is the Holy Spirit.
Come on.
Anytime your hair stand up on your arm, the back of your neck, any of that, that's the Holy Spirit in you. Mm. That's telling you something without telling you.
Right.
When your body is your senses have taken over. Mm-hmm. That is a prime example of what that is.
Okay.
So what I'm saying is we got to take it back to that spirituality of, you know, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, you know, that's just really what it is.
Okay.
And that's within yourself.
Good.
That don't come in no church. That don't come in no pastor, no preacher, no priest, no Buddhist, no higher up, no none of that.
Mm-hmm.
No man, let me say that. You know, we have to take it back to that of just doing instinctively what's right. All this shit for money. And if you notice, and just me and you talking from our experience with this new job journey that we're on. Mm-hmm. You don't even have to count how much your check is for real. Because from the deeds that you do, haven't you noticed that everything is always taken care of? Mm-hmm. Everything always works itself out.
Yeah.
Just from the deeds that you do, you don't even see yourself like overthinking, overstressing how you're going to make something happen. It always just falls into place.
Real talk.
And that's because we took out the idol worshiping of material shit, you know, chasing idol things,
mm-hmm.
you know, just. When you take it back to doing things for purpose, when you said, you made a comment earlier about this is your mission, you know, this is what God called you to do.
Mm-hmm.
I said that to you the first time I guest host on here.
You said it to me?
I said that on the show, that when I asked for this job,
okay.
I prayed for a job that would give me purpose
mm-hmm.
of doing something that just made me feel good.
Mm-hmm.
I've worked all over for the government, all private contract, all the stuff, made so much money and had all the stresses in the world trying to chase that check. When I stopped chasing the check and went to do something that was of service to somebody else, not to serve myself, everything around me started coming into place without me doing any extra work.
Yeah. Hey, and on that note, we're gonna go to a commercial break because we got an interview right now.
Okay.
We're going to keep it lit, though. This is Mad Mondays. We'll be back. Yeah, for real.
But it was good. Top five gangsters whose style was clean as Clorox. Let's get it. First on the list, I got to start off with old school Superfly Priest. The perm, the chops. We're not going to worry about the fact that a lot back in the 70s, the fabrics, they look like they just came off of a couch or something else, right? Wallpaper that was on a suit. The 70s was wild. But look, man, Priest was clean. They called him Superfly for a reason, right? Old school. I think my daddy was emulating this dude, to be honest, but that's a whole nother... Okay. Second on the list, this is not really a gangster movie, but Ocean's 11. Bruh, Rusty, I don't know what it was, okay? Looked like his suits was a little bit too big, you know what I mean? The way they fit, but they was cut clean, and he had a little style on it. I don't know why, but I love that. Hey, Rusty was clean. Rusty was clean. Gotta give him that. Number three, how can we not put Sam Rothstein, whatever, from Casino? This man was clean. Always suited, booted, fitted, fresh. The man was so crispy. He didn't even wear his pants when he sat down at the desk. They got a scene where he get up. He ain't got his pants on. He got them hanging on the side so that the crease don't get fucked up. So he don't get no wrinkles in his pants when he's sitting in his office. Come on. Sam Rothstein. All right, number two. Quick. Harlem Nights. Woo! Eddie was cold in this. Come on, man. You seen the fits? Matter of fact, yo, the whole cast was fitted in this one. I got it. That's the whole cast. But Quick, though, he led the pack in this one. Before I get to my number one, honorable mention, Michael Corleone from The Godfather fitted every time, all day, every day. Can't put him out. That's one of the GOATs. But my favorite, number one, Bumpy Johnson in Hoover. This dude was just, even in his casual, he had like a little casual fit. He was clean, cut, suited, right. And then the way he walked around with his hand in his little pocket right there, he always had his hand in his pocket. That shit was clean. And he was cold in Hoover. Lawrence Fishburne. Yes, Bumpy Johnson. That's my number one. So, there's a lot of good-ass gangster movies out there. Did I miss some? I don't know, but this was my five. What's yours?
Are we on the air?
Yes, you are.
You're live in the mix with the one and only.
One and only.
DJ Igor Beats.
What is it?
This that meth shit though, a big hit, turn it up and let this go. This'll change your bucket to a clean whip. Whoa. Head knocking, feeling me, and I mean this. Oh, as long as you feel it through you, nothing else matter. If you ain't about this bop, bop, tuck, tail, scatter. I'm slow-mo to this like Kane in the 50. Like I'm the one got it and can't shit get me. I'm throwing out smiles and mugs like Frisbees and catching like boomerangs, whatever niggas send me. I pull up on them knocking like, yeah, this is me. With cops in the rear view, fuck them, I'm busy. Until I hit the gated, baby, this one on repeat. The ape in the trunk, the only thing gon' beat me. Believe me, easily knock me down and leave me. These kind of DBs will make a nigga pee-pee. The center of it, the knock make them see me. I need their attention, sorry I'm greedy. Middle fingers up like love me or not. Pick your poison, mine is that ba-ba. This is that to the left, I'm vibing. Dynamite like knock right, not guiding. I'm going, I'm going. Might as well say Biden. I did. You should have took the photo. And here, I'm the party in the ride. It's a show though. So turn it up and turn up. The fight back on. Yeah, now your bottom and your back getting slapped on. Gotta love the knock though. Knocked up, knocked out. Knocked off a head knock. You knocking.
in or nodding out. Knock it down, knocking on it. Finally, I got you on it. Ooh. Got massaged on it. Knock is a problem opponent. Old school or spaceship, I'ma have rattle. I'm knock life sentence, been lost that battle. It still made Tigra and Bunny turn bop. Left the boom behind, now they on bop. This is that. They pull up on me, they be trying to race me. But I won't even hear them lest they master ace me. Face say I'm chilling in the building, gravy. I'm doing me, knocking, how can any nigga hate me? Thanks, that tell me I've been looking good lately. But these niggas on me trying to rob me, maybe. But probably not, what it do? Going for this knock, turn a nigga into Tupac, bruh. If you thinking you got a choice, you do not. There's your green light there, gone, get the scoop, nigga. I'm right back into the movement, rocking my behind the wheel two-step, doing it. This is that. This is that.
Fucking with it, man. We live. We back on. Welcome to Mad Mondays, man. This is exclusive. I've been asking this nigga hella long ago to come do this song. Oh, yeah.
Turn my shit up, man.
Yeah. Shout out to Too Short.
Welcome to East Oakland.
Come on, man. Got my nigga DJ in the motherfucking building. I didn't even know he was a rapper. Right. She like, who is his? I'm like, him. It's Too Short, but it's him. Listen. Oh.
Welcome to Oakland, man.
Oh, you gonna do it just, oh,
yeah,
you
gonna, man. Fuck okay. That. I know my words.
Oh.
Know, let me kick that shit.
Okay,
hold
well,
on.
Come in. Come on. Come on.
I'm from East Oakland, 600 and Mac, where niggas swung donuts and sold ounces of crack with a gun in their back while watching the Mac, knocking old school short nigga born to Mac. In the city of dope, but not a lot of hope. Can hang yourself and we'll give you the rope. You'll see a Mustang really dancing in the rain. Real Falcons and Cougars, old school, old plan. I passed through the north, they hollering 456. Them niggas deep as fucking, they'll take your bitch. And then I went to Dogtown, I was looking for blood because I got so much love, just wanted to give them a hug. I love my city, nigga, what about you? If the shit jump up, fuck you gon' do. I know what we gon' do, due to what we've been through. It's an Oakland secret, but I'll tell it to you. Life is. Hey, Igor, bring it back in with my verse on, because that was all skip.
Ooh.
I thought you was going to bring it with my verse,
ooh,
man.
Hey, that was some professional shit right there, my nigga.
Nigga. Come on, man. Put my verse on that bitch, man. Hello.
Ooh,
welcome to the town, nigga.
Yeah, all right.
Yeah, man. Welcome to Mad Mondays, my motherfucker. Shout out DJ Igor Whiteout, whole
hello.
Bay lifestyle. Hey, welcome to Oakland, man.
Good without your lyrics, nigga.
Fucking right,
lyrics.
Here we go.
Come on.
I'm from East Oakland, 600 and Mac, where niggas swung donuts and sold ounces of crack with a gun in their back while watching the Mac. Knocking old school short, nigga, born the Mac. In the city, you dope, but not a lot of hope. You can hang yourself and we'll give you the rope. You'll see a Mustang really dancing in the rain. Real Falcons and Cougars, old school. I was looking for
Straight up, nigga. Shout out to the town, nigga. East Oakland, West Oakland, North Oakland. Look, check this out. I turned 16 in a dope beat rental. Kick dope beat rhyme to the knock on Plymouth. Woke up in the morning, it's the same old shit. Hit the block, turn some knives, get right back to the bitch. I'ma break this hoe for every dollar she got, and then have some recaps and drive her back to the spot. This old school Oakland that I'm talking about. You do some foul ass shit, you get socked in the mouth. Some niggas players, some niggas pimps. Either way, Oakland niggas don't take no shit. Knocking old school delinquents in the alleyway. Hoping I ain't gotta get up on a nigga today. O-A-K-L-A-N-D. Why niggas macking in my biggest sideways in the streets? It's just an Oakland tale, so don't be no punk. And be ready to catch a body if a nigga run up like this. Shout out to the town, man. He's up with West Oakland, North Oakland. He's up with DJ 600, nigga.
Hello.
Mac boy. Hello. Welcome to Mad Monday, man. Well, yeah. Shout out Bay Life.
Without further ado, ladies Hello. And gentlemen, all the way from Hello. East Oakland, California, give it up for DJ one
Come
time,
on,
y'all.
Man. Give me a little something, man.
Come on, man.
Give me a little something, man. What's
you know
the
how
town,
we
man?
Do it.
What's up, baby? Bay Life!
You don't know how we do it.
Come on, man.
That's how you come on to an interview, my nigga.
Come on, man.
I don't think I had no rapper do a freestyle. I mean, like, I ain't even.
Second
time. That wasn't a freestyle. That was the instrumental, but he came off the head.
Yeah, but
Igor, that's what you be asking for. From a lot of these niggas, and they don't do it. This nigga just came in here and killed that shit. I can't wait to watch it again.
He was phenomenal.
DJ.
Shout out to the town, man. East Oakland, West Oakland, North.
Another freestyle that was good in the beginning.
The girl? The guy?
Remember when you asked him to freestyle and he took off and he was like, okay.
Who was that, the poet?
Yes.
Who was that, Igor? We didn't have videos. I mean, sorry, we didn't have. No, Broski.
He didn't rap. It was somebody else that just took off.
But I know the female did it too. I recorded her shit. She came out the head. But a lot of people don't do
that.
But that's what Lil Big Cuz. That's what Lil Big Cuz.
Super energy.
Yeah,
that was a lot of energy.
I appreciate that.
That nigga got that off his chest, huh?
Hey man, let me get y'all a little background on that song, man. It was like 3 o'clock in the morning, right? And I just couldn't sleep. And I just had that beat in my head. And I'm thinking to myself, why is it? And I had to be at work at 6 in the morning. I'm like, first of all, why am I awake? And why is this beat in my fucking head? I just had that boom, boom, ch, ba boom, boom. And it was in my head so much. I just picked up my phone, said, let me just try to fuck around. And man, I wrote the first verse in bed at 3 something in the morning. And the second verse, I wrote the rest of that shit at work. Like,
oh, wow.
You know what I mean? Like, I was like, where did shit come from? I knew it was special though. And I knew it was for the town, man. Cause you know what I'm saying?
Good.
Out here in Oakland, we going through so much, even though I know every other city is too, but this our city, this our side. So we focus more so on us, but we love everybody. But I just knew this was something special for the town. And really, White, Igor, I ain't even did nothing with this song. It's
right,
just
I'm
sitting.
I'm like, this nigga hella boozy.
It's
like,
just sitting.
I bled. That was like, what, 2 months ago, nigga, I first heard
so
it?
So look, let me finish telling you this.
Please
so look,
do.
So I hit hooker because I took the shit to Fab.
Oh,
I went to the club. I went to Desi's Lounge. Shout out to Fab. My cousin took me up there. I didn't want to go. My cousin like, bruh, you got to let Fab hear the song. He going to be at the club tonight. I'm like, all right, let's go. We go up there, Fab up there. He like, let me hear it. This nigga told the DJ, man, turn this nigga shit on. He turned my shit on, and he was like, first, only thing he said was, bruh, film the video, and I'll get it to Pops. You know,
oh,
for
I remember.
For all those
okay.
who know, for all
I
those
remember.
Who, for all those who know, his Pops is too short. He like, bruh, film the video so I can bring him a full project.
That's not
so
that nigga
boom.
Daddy.
Look, check this out. I know that, but just listen
yeah,
to what I'm saying.
Yeah,
man,
don't say that, though.
All right, bro, so look, so I hit Hooker Boy. I hit Hooker Boy like, yo, I need to film the video.
What the fuck?
He gave me the jug.
Is that what that nigga be saying?
Come on, man, am I telling my story, man? So
go
look,
ahead,
bud.
You fucked me up with that, though. Like,
no, but I'm just, because you know, Fab and they always say Pops and Son. That's no big deal. Like, let me finish the story.
I don't be hearing
so
that.
So look, okay, so Fab said film the video. So I hit Hooker Boy. He give me a player price. I get this nigga the player price. This is why Hooker Boy has nothing, because people keep saying, Hooker Boy is my friend. That's my big brother. I love this nigga. In this video, Igor was even mad at me. You know what I mean? Like, my shit wasn't ready. Like, Hooker Boy hit me that morning like, bro, I got the cars, we got the spot, I got the camera, let's go, let's film. It was my fault because my shit wasn't ready, so I canceled the video. So now that Hooker Boy ain't supposed to stay on standby, y'all see how busy this man is with the movies and the projects and the videos and the mic drops. And, bro, that is my friend. I've been respecting that man since I was a teenager. Rest in peace to Hennessy. Nigga, he used to always be with him. I used to always see them in that purple shell, bro. So I'm taking it back to old school East Oakland, man. And I love you, Hooker Boy, nigga. Fuck what the niggas talking about, nigga. And we still gonna do the video. I seen that nigga at 510 day. He said we gonna get it on. But he a busy man. But that's my nigga. So I'm glad I got that out the way. But other than that, man, I'm just macking and mobbing, nigga, trying to keep my shit cracking around this motherfucker. Nigga, he's talking. What's happening?
Can we at least have a copy of the shit so I can play that shit on my podcast?
For sure. You can add this bitch, bro. I'm
right.
Yeah, you can
been,
add that
I've been
shit.
Wanting it since I heard it. I remember the video was supposed to came out. I remember motherfuckers mad at you. And nigga, what you waiting on now?
Keep it 100. What you? Something nice about the girls in Oakland. I mean,
God. Hey, you know what? It's funny you say that.
They didn't hear what you said. They didn't hear what you said.
I just want to say, when are you going to get inspired to say something nice about the ladies from Oakland?
Hey, you know what? It's funny you say that because I am involved with a very beautiful young lady right now, and she means the world to me. And I do need to get my pen back to that pad. You know what I mean? And not just for her, just for do something for the females. But you know.
Yeah.
She really inspires me, and she's really special to me. And I'm in a doghouse right now, but I'm gonna try to, climb out. I didn't do nothing like really bad, but I just be doing, you know, how niggas be do dumbass shit sometimes, just unnecessary little shit. But hey, shout out to you, baby. You know I love you.
What's her name?
Hey man, her name is her name. You know what I'm talking about? Yeah, she from the
hood.
She from around this motherfucker, man. You know what I'm talking about? Love you, baby.
Hey, he love you, but he left her. That nigga said I'm in the doghouse right now, but
trying to get out.
But I love
her.
Well, hopefully she sees this, man. We gonna send you a copy of this shit so you can send it to her.
Oh no,
look at 53 minutes and point.
I think she might be watching live right now. I sent it to her.
Okay.
If you watching, hey baby.
Nigga wouldn't say your name though, but
shout out
baby.
Her name.
Hey, this nigga in the doghouse for real now. Like you didn't say my name.
I'll say her name.
Say her name,
nigga. Because I don't know if she want me to say her name.
But she don't love her like you love her.
Hey, hold on. Hey, Miss Regina Albert, I love you.
Oh,
baby.
Shit.
Uh-oh.
Come on, man.
I better find her on Facebook.
That's why I won't be doing that. See? No, high four, nigga.
Shout out her name.
He shook my hand with the right.
I love Bay Life Radio, man. Whenever I come over here, man, I love the staff, everybody, man. It's all laid out. Y'all should really come check this shit out, man.
Nigga.
This is a real experience, bro. We out here in the town, nigga.
Blood,
you know what I'm saying? Like, niggas from the town don't really be doing it like this. Like, bro, Igor, the way he got his shit set up, bro, white out, bro. I always appreciate y'all, bro. I think about y'all all the time, bro. I'm always watching y'all shit, nigga.
Nigga.
Keep that shit cracking, nigga.
Send
up,
this
nigga.
Shit to her when
oh
it's over, nigga, and
oh
I guarantee you. Fucking enough.
I'm never coming. Hey, and this is like my what? Hey, this is like my seventh time on the show. Last season, I was on this bitch five.
This was different, though. This was different, White.
Okay.
Oh, this was different. You freestyled your new song that people ain't even heard.
It wasn't a freestyle, brother.
No, okay, your song, nigga.
Okay.
Your song. It's not a freestyle.
You got new. Oh, I didn't see that.
Man, I'm just not a little bit, man. I ain't doing too much. Looking harder.
Let me know
Hey, so no, but I'm saying though, you came out here, and nigga came straight to this motherfucker, fresh off work, got dressed, got clean. Shout out to who made them hoodies?
Nigga Marco, East Oakland's finest. You feel me? Black, white, corduroy, everything, coats, jackets, hoodies, socks, all the shit, nigga. The closet full of this shit.
I thought
nigga.
You said that nigga
Catch
was from
up.
West Oakland.
What?
I thought you said he was from West Oakland.
No, I did not say that. You heard it wrong, brother. He's from the East, bro.
I could have sworn you said
Rewind
that.
Rewind it.
What's his name again?
Marco.
Marco.
From the East, bruh.
Shout out to my nigga.
Hello.
Cause them motherfuckers clean, though. Tap in if you know him.
Like
go to his IG page and support
yeah,
that.
I'm for
That's
sure going.
Real town shit right there.
I'm for sure gonna post that shit on my page, man. Get my nigga up, but he already up, but I'm gonna get him up more.
Yeah,
get
for
him
sure.
Up more, you know what I'm
saying? For sure. Okay, so yeah, nigga, I'm glad you came through and did your fucking song, Blood. Like,
man,
for real.
Sure.
I heard that shit and was really like, I was juiced. Like, Blood, I was really proud. I was really, I was waiting on the video. You know what I'm saying?
It's
coming. I was like, okay, this nigga fucking with it right here. This is gonna be that one. Have you had the opportunity to have show listen to it?
Not yet, because Fab said until I film the video, he's not gonna present the project to him. Which is correct. You know what I mean? So I gotta step my game up. You know what I mean? I get so busy tied up in life dealing with bills, kids, life, and I'll be forgetting about that little song till I'll be at a liquor store with some, bro, I heard you. And I'll be like, oh,
can
yeah.
I say that it has the same kind of energy as Not Like Us a little? It gives that Oakland feeling the same, like how LA feels like Not Like Us is them. That beat,
I hear you. I heard
I mean,
you.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah, yeah,
that
yeah, yeah.
Beat, and then, you know,
yeah,
how he's
that old
just
school
constantly
to, life
yeah.
is. Yeah.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
It gives that same feeling like Not Like Us as far as that hype feeling for Oakland. It's a pride feeling.
Okay, now see, I hear what you're saying. I hear you.
I heard her.
No,
too.
I was juicing the motherfucker. Like, I've been wanting to hear the song. I didn't ask the nigga. The video got canceled with hella shit. So I really, like, I fuck with the song for sure. And the nigga came out and sung it. But my thing is, but I don't agree with making a video first. Like, honestly, nigga, I would want Show to hear my shit and then possibly have that nigga in the video.
Man, I would love that, but goddamn, that's like spit. That's like buying a lotto ticket, helping you get that million.
No, that's just networking, my nigga. For real, because you basically paying homage to Show.
Why would that be like buying a lotto ticket?
I would love to.
That's reviving his.
Am I spending it again?
Kendrick ran it back 5 times. I'm only on 2.
Hold on. Here you go. Here go 3.
That's 3.
No, that's 3. Okay. Kendrick, I ain't trying to catch up to you, bro. I'm
going
to let you have a 5, man. Shout out to Kendrick, man. Everybody in Compton, man. They smashing right now, man. You know what I'm saying? Them our cousins, nigga. Really on some Oakland Compton shit, LA shit in general. Nigga, we really like cousins. You know what I'm talking about? So shout out to them niggas. They on a wave right now. Just hope all them niggas be safe because, nigga, I know they on one.
Right.
Uh-oh.
You ain't crip walking it is, nigga.
Hell no. That's a mob shit, man.
Right.
You feel me?
You gonna bob your head to
Come
it, but nigga,
man.
You ain't finna be crip walking
hey,
and
man,
dancing
turn me
and
up.
Shit.
Turn me up. Sure.
So Blood. So okay. So a video coming?
Yeah, man. I just gotta hook up with Hooker Boy. You know what I mean? Tap in with him. See when his availabilities
this
are.
This nigga came last Monday and all right, man. I'm gonna have to hit that nigga. Bro.
Yeah, I'm
gonna tell him you ready.
In.
Are you gonna
I'm
be ready soon?
I'm gonna tap in with the good guy, man. And when I finish video, man, this mother, bruh. Cause let me tell you this before I go. So I was talking to Yuck Mouth, bruh, like a month ago. I caught him slipping where I caught him slipping at. And he was, but I heard him say it in interviews, but him telling me in my face, like, bruh, when they did 5 on it, they put that shit in a vault for 2 years, bruh. And they was just recording. Cause when they recorded that song, they knew it was a hit. They sat on that for 2 years. This song is only 6 months. So it's not like, well, Igor, I recorded with you. Is it even 6 months?
It need to be out, though. Fuck that.
I know.
It need to be out.
All right, so it's coming, man. It's coming, man. Just stay patient with me. I'm going to come with some more shit. You know what I'm saying?
It need to be out, my nigga.
I'm going to come with some more shit.
It's the summer, nigga.
I know.
It's time, man.
Come on, man. I'm on it, bro.
I'm gonna have you perform in my Bay Boy comedy reunion.
Let me do that. I would love to do that.
Boom.
I would love to do that.
Boom.
You do comedy too?
No.
Nigga, I did comedy at your motherfucking other set at the. It sucked. But you know what? It was a check off the bucket list. I was supposed to bomb.
You remember that shit?
I don't think I bombed.
You remember that shit?
But you know what?
Up there, he tried to perform.
He on one. it's something I always wanted to do. Right. Like, check it off my bucket list. And I just came with three little whack jokes, but I did it. And I said,
you did do it.
That takes a lot, bruh. It takes to get. And this nigga had the house packed. It was full of people. I mean, we got.
Hey, somebody, P just texted me and said, put him on a show to do the song. Boom. I just did it.
Yeah, I'm coming through.
It's official.
It's good. I'm coming through. I'm
so
slide.
tell niggas.
When is the show?
August 3rd, nigga.
It's good, bro.
August 3rd, Bay Boy Comedy Reunion Show, Black Repertory Theater. You know about the Blap.
Man, come on, man.
So come on, man.
I don't even know who's performing, but I know they're all my friends.
Here go the flyer right here. It's the Bay Boys, nigga.
Hello.
It's the Bay Boys.
So, hey, so you gonna put me on the flyer? On the new flyer, man?
No, ain't no new flyer, but you can make your own, though.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? People do that.
DJ will be performing at the Bay Boys of Comedy Reunion Show. You know what I'm saying? August 3rd on a Saturday. Yeah, we in the building, man. We're going to turn up for real, man.
There you have it. You want to give a shout-out to anybody, loved one?
Man, shout-out, man, my family, my woman, my job, my house. Everybody, man, shout-out to everybody, man. Shit, everybody just keep doing y'all thing, nigga. Straight up.
I love the fuck out of you, bud.
Already,
I definitely
nigga, this
appreciate
real
you pulling up.
Nigga. I might be hyphy, but I'm me, nigga.
Where can they find you at?
Nigga can find me, nigga, wherever. Nigga, I'm on.
That's some Oakland shit for real.
Nigga, I'm everywhere. That's somewhere, nigga. I'm all over the place like space, nigga. Everywhere like air, nigga. Believe that. But on Instagram, I'm East Oakland DJ number 2. If you want to follow my boosy ass, nigga, we up, though. What's happening?
This nigga crazy.
Straight up,
shout
nigga.
Out to Pops, too, man.
Hey, love my Pops, man. Yeah, I sure miss you, man. We was just rekindling our relationship, and I fucked it up again, man.
I'll talk to you off camera about that.
One more thing I want to say before we get off the air. I don't know if these people who listening know. My first name and his first name and my daddy first name, we all got the first name.
And my daddy first name.
And your father's first name. Shout out, man. R.I.P. to Pops, man. So we all Dwight's, bro. So I always hold you at a higher standard, bro. Because when I was a little kid, a teenager, bro, when I was over there taking karate, bro, and you was over there busting chicken wings at KFC, nigga. Nigga, you took me up under your wing. Not the chicken wing, but the wing. You feel me? You always took a liking to me, bro. And I always hold a higher standard of respect for you, bro. Sure. Like, you my big brother, and I love you. Shout out my nigga White out. Dwight, nigga.
For sure. Hey, well, there you have it, man. You can see him on the show. Do you have any shows before that?
I'm about to perform tonight, Jack, at the Artist Retreat. Hello.
Well, there you have it.
Hey, man, when you come outside, stay out, man. We
come outside, fuck with my nigga, but he would definitely be on the show August the 3rd at the Black Repertory Theater.
I love you for that.
Yeah, it's all love, nigga. You know what I'm saying? I fuck with who fuck with me. And yes, you came through and represented like a true artist should. And, nigga, I got a platform for you, just like this one. So I definitely appreciate you coming, bro.
Sure.
Keep doing your thing. And yes, for all the people that's watching right now, you'll see him August the 3rd. We'll be back after these messages. This is Mad Money.
Stokeland.
So you just got off work and you're going to perform again?
Yep.
This is it.
I'm off till Thursday.
Okay, well, yeah, you'll sleep till then.
I get up at 3:30.
Crazy people don't get off.
www.m4mmunited.org, or you can call us at 877-900-0832.
Live by the sword, die by the sword. A common expression adapted from Jesus. Words to Peter, the proverb meaning is still basically the same. A person. violence. Those who practice violence will come to a violent end. I say it again. Those who practice violence will come to a violent end.
I used to shoot all my videos with hookah.
Back in the building. This ain't no drop, cause we ain't dropped nothing. Peep the work. I'm coming up out of the basement, stepping up over you niggas to get to the first floor. So pass the dope so I can fuck it up some more and watch me kick the style that I'm used to. Turn it up a little bit louder, my nigga, to tell me who's the man. Watch your girl before I fuck her. But you can have her back though, cause you my motherfucker. But if you wanna flex it, I suggest that you step back, or else you'll be 5'10" show of a six pack. And I'll be back to the swing that I'm swinging. The opera ain't over, cause Oprah ain't singing. And now you know that when you be passing me the dough, man, I get funky. Shouldn't have got me started, cause now I'm hooked like a jokey. Hip-hop, jokey. I'm flipping up my words so that my lyrics will be funky. I'm coming up out of Oakland, my nigga. That's where the best be. Basement and Baylight. Testing 1, 2, 3. My mic sounds nice like salt and pepper. I'm switching up my words so that I'm not a half-stepper. Cause it ain't no half-stepping. Pass me the dope and now I'm loaded like a weapon. And bam! Just like Redman flexed up. Please get ready for the next nigga up. Yo, but hold on. Wait a minute. Slow down, my nucka. Your boy Rich Hines in the house, motherfucker.
What did he do? I got an hour left to get paid for it.
You paid for it.
I know, but I'm just saying. I just started.
This is Mad Monday. See, that's the difference. See, women, y'all be crazy than a motherfucker. I explain some shit about my motherfucking benefits and shit that I got going on, and she want to top my shit, talking about when I get paid. I get 2 hours worth off of her lunch. I don't give a fuck. I'm happy with the hour I get and get paid for it. I'm good
be
with that.
Be grateful.
Welcome back. This is Mad Mondays. I'm your host, Whiteout, a.k.a. 2. And with me today has been... that nigga speaking Spanish.
What?
My co-host for the day is Miss Ayana.
Yes, yes. Ayana smiles one time.
Okay. Good. I don't know. I think
blank
I'm losing my shit.
Every time.
But thank you. I appreciate you. Do you want to give a shout out to anybody?
I do. So I have a cousin that is just coming back into his lyrics and being a lyricist. His name is Primo, and Black C from RBL. They just dropped Bay Bosses. So it's available on all platforms, all streaming platforms. If anybody want to check out some more mature rap, yeah, I'm not going to say mature rap. I only heard 2 songs. But
yeah, because I was like, what the fuck?
Okay, wrong word.
You just
this
DJ
wrong,
shit?
wrong word, not mature rap, but... Bay Boss.
Conscious.
It's some player shit.
Okay.
From what I heard, it was some player shit. Like,
so it didn't use no curse words?
I ain't going to say that.
Okay.
I'm not going to say that. It was just some player shit.
Well, now I got to hear it.
Yeah.
So I can give
listen
you my two
to
cents.
It. Listen to it.
What's
everybody
the name of them again?
Check out Bay Bosses.
Bay Bosses?
Yeah.
That's the name of the song?
That's the name of the album, the EP.
Okay.
Yeah, it's Primo and Black Sea.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. I'm going to
look
that up.
It's a compilation. They don't hard copy anything. I'm one of those that reads the credits on the back of an album. I want to see who wrote stuff, the executive producer. Like, back in the day, we bought albums.
Remember when niggas ended the album, they used to give a long-ass shout-out
yes,
over a song.
And thank hella people. And at the end on the album, they would write out
a little
all
because
people.
You remember that shit? There used to be a whole song, nigga, just shouting out everybody.
Yes.
You did it? That's old school, though. That was love, though. You know
I
what I'm saying?
That.
Like, nigga, they gave a shout-out to everybody. You have anything coming up? Any events or anything coming up?
We have a new construction EPA cohort 24 beginning on August 12th. Orientation and stuff begins on July 29th. So, yeah, we're taking applications, letters of reference, recommendation for people who want to join the construction classes. It is a 12-week course. At this time, it's unpaid, but you do a obtained 9 certifications, including janitorial. We just added to it.
That's what's up. Where can they find that information at?
It is probably, I will post it on my Instagram.
What's your Instagram?
Yana Smiles 1.
Can you spell it?
Whoa. Y-A-N-N-A, Smiles with an S, number 1.
Okay. Okay. Thank you. I appreciate you.
I appreciate you for having me. Thank you again. And, yeah, I like it.
Little Big Cuz, what you got going on this week, man? Or the next 2 weeks, because I ain't going to be here next Monday.
This week, let me see what I got going on this week. This week, we got Artist Retreat tonight. We got Artist Retreat tonight. Come through, artist welcome. 2 songs, $10 cover. Don't hit me for no VIP. If you can't afford to go, stay in the house. Simple as that. It is a 420 friendly environment. Tuesday night, we at Sweet Fingers. Every first Tuesday, it's an artist mixer right there at Sweet Fingers, What It Do Tuesdays. If you know, you know. Artists, if you don't know, show up at 8 o'clock, have 2 songs ready. It is a $10 cover at the door. You feel me? Yeah. Fridays, town nights. We got 4 more weeks, y'all. This Friday, bring the kids out. We in 8 different parks across Oakland, California. Everything is free for all the kids. Yeah, come out. And of course, Friday night, I'm at the Aloha Bar at Eva!
Alright, so shit. You got shit cracking. We won't be back next Monday. I will be on a cruise going to Mexico.
Safe travels.
Thank you, brother. I will be back the following Monday. As far as this month, I got a birthday party for, Darnell. It's an Oscar themed birthday party. He giving away awards and hella shit. I'm performing at that, so that's like something. That's like some shit that everybody don't know about.
Okay.
And then July 27th, all my Fremont High alumni. We still got a couple of tickets on sale for the Fremont reunion at Scott's Jack Lennon Square. Lil Cuz, you still got that, right?
What date?
The 27th.
Of this month?
Yeah, that's the Fremont reunion.
Fremont reunion? Yeah, I still got that. All right, bro.
And then, shit, August the 3rd, Black Repertory Theater. August 17th, I got Frisco with out there at Coachman Row. It's a award ceremony, too. I'm going to be hosting that. Yeah, we'll show you a flyer for that. I think the tickets is not on sale no more. September 5th. I think that shit's sold out.
The 17th is sold out?
I think so, yeah. I'm going to have to tap into Coach Monroe. Shout out to Coach Monroe, Mac alumni. September 14th at the Bricks.
Dang. How far your calendar going out? People supposed
November
to
2nd,
this?
I rebooked at the Black Rev, but I don't know about that right now. But September 14th, put that on the calendar too, Big Lil, because we're at the Bricks in Oakland. Yeah, man, shit, I'm trying to stay busy.
I see that.
I'm trying to get paid.
I was saying,
I'm trying to get
giving
paid
people the
legit
itinerary.
And then my hustle.
But I'm saying giving people your itinerary months in advance is easier for people to forget.
I'll put that shit on your calendar.
Today's just the 1st of July.
I understand
you're talking
that.
About September.
Yeah,
rock it all
put,
month.
Put that shit on your calendar.
Right. We're going to tell you every week.
I'm learning how, we're going to tell you every week for sure.
Okay.
But I definitely appreciate everybody for tuning in. I definitely appreciate my co-host as well as my DJ. I'll see y'all in 2 weeks. Please be safe in these streets. Keep supporting Bay Life Radio. Because without y'all, wouldn't be no us, man. So I definitely appreciate the support as well as everybody a part of the team. And we'll see y'all in 2 Mondays, man, or see y'all in the streets. On that note, God bless everybody. 2 out.
Yeah, I'm with the funnies, yep. Laughing out loud, man, that's how I get this money, boy style. Man, you know how I'm moving, man, you see what I'm doing, all the paper I'm pursuing, boy style. Yeah, I'm with the funnies, yep. Laughing out loud, man, that's how I get this money, boy style. California live, California live, California live, California live, California live.